Okay, that was kind of a little bit of an unnecessary trip there you guys took. And put you up here where you're just a little safer. You've seen what it is I'm going to adjust anyway. Oh my gosh. That's how these are adjusted. Never ever adjusted one of these before. So that's interesting. That's on the FM. And of course we're trying to boost the FM as much as we can. Now I got zero antenna connected to the FM side, which is not such a good thing. I'd really like to have some kind of antenna connected. So let's the easiest way of doing this. Now it's a very special plug to for the FM antenna to go in, so you can't make a mistake when it's back in the cabinet. But here I don't have the cabinet, I don't have that plug. So it's a question of doing that. Take the signal generator off of it. I guess I better put on my FM. My FM-er. Yeah, no idea these are so easy to adjust. In fact, they're so easy, they're pretty easy to knock out of adjustment. When I changed the magic eye here, I fiddled around right in this area. I could have knocked one of these out of adjustment. Okay, quick safety check before we power up. FM. Don't know for sure I have this antenna. I have no antenna connected right now. Because we're going to try to rely on my little FM broadcaster. So I think we're safe to fire up the radio. There we go. Certainly are some strange things that go on in the FM side on this guy. Okay, let's see if we can find my transmitter. Once, twice, there's the real one. Can you touch these things? Makes a good difference. Interesting. Just touching them sends the signal up. Now, how am I supposed to adjust that with a tool? Can't be done with that. Thank you. We'll try a rubber glove, but there still might be too much capacitance here. Not bad. Oh, getting a big boost on this. Oh my gosh. Got a huge boost. Wow. That's pretty good. Now I'm pretty excited about trying this on the antenna. Okay, turn off my signal generator, plug in the antenna. Again, I'm not sure this is connected here. Could be I put it into the ground pin on the antenna connection. Jeez. What are those? I like that. I like that, eh? So that's what it was. These two adjustments. That's what it was all this time. You know, my usual experience is alignment doesn't do much on most radios. It peaks them up a little bit, you know. I can get the same effect by turning the volume up, really. But this one, wow. Now, let's see what the instructions say about performing those tests. Maybe there's a better way to, or those adjustments. Maybe there's a better way. So I'm going to study that. Okay, so I'm performing now the FM alignment, a more careful FM alignment than my initial one, to really try to get the most out of this radio. So, okay, so that signal is coming from the FM generator. something is drifting, either the signal it's coming out of my test unit, which is quite possible it's drifting, or the radio itself is drifting around. So while I'm making these adjustments, it's tuning itself. It's making it a little bit tricky. Okay, those ones are pretty much maxed out. No more oscillation there. We're getting a little FM there. With no real antenna on it. How do you like that? It's gotten much, much better. But before I say too much, certainly make it louder, but I think there's some oscillations that come with that. Ooh, that's my transmitter. I think we better tune in a real signal here at this point. No reaction from the magic eye at all. Okay, stick with one thing. Let's put a real signal into this radio. Oh, it does. Oh, I'll take it back. It is connected. Okay, since it is, let's see what we get. A weak signal there. No, I had it receiving much better. I suspect the antenna is not working the way I think it is, so let's try something a little different there. Hoo-ha! It is working better. That's what we need.
Just once, please try not to be so mean. Whoa.
Well, I think that's pretty good. I think I can declare the radio finished. Lots of volume too. Yeah, shouldn't turn it up too loud. There we go. So, it's a long journey. Why don't I just review quickly what all we went through. A couple of dead tubes. Alignment way off on the FM side, way off. On the shortwave side, one band not working just because the contacts, I hadn't cleaned them properly the first time through. Hum, it's still humming a little bit. It's not much though. The hum solved with these capacitors up here. Yeah, and then the extensive alignment, first a rough alignment to discover if there is any need to do an alignment and to bring the radio up so I could work on it better, and then a second alignment, a very careful one, really trying to max out everything. On the FM side, the alignment procedures here, I can't follow them, they're too complicated, so I simply perform the technique's very similar to what you do on the AM side. I'm mostly using an FM signal through the antenna and not doing anything injected into the IF. And that seemed to get me where I needed to go. Initially I was anxious about turning any of the adjustments on the FM because my understanding is I don't understand. So if I start twiddling a bunch of adjustments, I'm gonna just going to make a mess of things. And I have done enough of this kind of work to know there are very, let's say, non-intuitive approaches that don't involve listening to anything. They have to involve adjusting things and getting voltages right, stuff like that. So I know that's there, but I just did it more or less by ear and by output strength using a meter. A meter is very important. Couldn't achieve this with your ear. And so that's the bottom line. A couple of bad tubes and an alignment is really what this thing was looking for. And I've operated it many, many, many hours down here now. It only caught fire once, but it won't do that again, that's for sure. So there we are. Hope you enjoyed all that. And we'll see you on the next radio, which is in my trunk waiting to come in here.